Now the next topic is characteristics of elements. So the first characteristic is each element consists of only one kind of atoms, but these atoms different from the atoms of other elements. Means किन्हीं भी दो elements के atoms अलग अलग होते हैं. कोई भी दो element same kind of atom से मिलकर नहीं बन सकता. Okay. Now second is an element is composed either of individual atoms or of molecules made up of atoms. So element can be composed of single atoms or it can be made up of molecule that is formed by atoms. Now third is element are pure and homogeneous. Homogeneous means their composition is uniform throughout the bulk. Now next is elements have fixed melting and boiling point. Their melting and boiling point is fixed. And next is element cannot be broken down into more simpler substances exhibiting its properties. That I have already explained you that elements cannot be broken down into simpler substances than itself by any physical or chemical process. Now next is elements may react chemically with other elements and compound like hydrogen and chlorine. When hydrogen react with chlorine, it will form HCl. So elements can combine with another elements and compounds. Okay. Now next is the classification of elements. So on the basis of their properties, elements are classified into metals, non-metals, metalloids and noble or inert gases. So first is metals. So what are metals? Most of the elements known to us are metals. They are monoatomic. Monoatomic means single atom. They are made up of single atom. Most of them are hard solids. So most of the metals are hard solids, but some exceptions are there. Some of the example of metals are magnesium, copper, silver, iron. Okay. Now next is the non-metals. Non-metals are mostly polyatomic in nature. Polyatomic means they can be made up of different atoms, different number of atoms. That is, their molecules contain 2, 3 or more atoms. Means their molecule can contain 2, 3 or more atom. Example is oxygen. Oxygen, it contains 2 atoms in its molecule, O2. So that contains 2 atoms. Now phosphorus has 4 atoms. Okay. They are very less in number in comparison to metal. So if we compare non-metals with metals, so their number is very less as compared to metals. There are only 11 non-metals excluding noble gases. If we exclude noble gases, then there are only 11 non-metals that is known to us. And they exist in all the three physical state, that is solid, liquid and gases. Okay. Now the next is metalloids. These are monoatomic elements showing some properties of metals and some properties of non-metals. So metalloids are those substances which are monoatomic. And they can show the properties of both metals as well as non-metals. They are hard. Some of the examples are boron, arsenic, antimony, silicon. Now next is the inert or noble gases. These are the monoatomic gases elements which do not react chemically with other elements or compound. So they are known as noble or inert gases. So what are noble or inert gases? These are the substances which do not react with other elements. Okay. These are the gases elements. They do not react with other elements. That's why they are known as noble or inert gases. They are found in air in traces and there are only 6 in number. That are helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon.